in a web show, a story is told in say 400 minutes or something.
How would a Salman Khan film do? How much would the viewers enjoy it without the accompanying hullabaloo?
Today we are talking about OTT platforms and what is happening right here, right now. 2-3 years down the line, we'll be talking about something else because the technology has not stopped developing.
Sir, your thoughts on OTT platforms? There is no Damocles sword hanging on the heads that the Friday has to have certain numbers, the weekend has to have certain numbers.
Yeah, it's the future. It's the future. I have been, in fact, saying for some time now that I think in 25 years there'll be no cinema halls left. They'll turn into shopping centers or something, or restaurants. Everybody will be watching movies at home, and that is the future. It's a very interesting thing. It will be to observe how a film which provokes massive hysteria and whistling and clapping and throwing money at the screen and all in a large theater would fare on an OTT platform. How would a Salman Khan film do? How much would the viewers enjoy it without the accompanying hullabaloo, which is part of that film? You know, it's like if I were watching an IPL match all alone in a stadium, you know, I don't think it'd be that much fun.
Okay, and what about you, Atul? What is your opinion? Because, you know, the interesting part about the OTT platforms is that it is a very democratic space. There is no specification that ye hero hai, ye heroine hai, ye supporting star cast hai. Anyone can be the protagonist, irrespective of the age or sex or anything whatsoever. And it's a story that really, and how well it is told, that really matters.
I think it's a great thing for actors. Why I am interested in OTT platforms is because it is something what in between theater and cinema, according to me. Because what happens, I'll tell you, is that in theater, you do a performance and then you keep on repeating it. I remember once I was traveling back from somewhere with Gulzar Saab, and I'm doing a play called Kharashein, which is written by him. I mean, it's a collage of his stories and poems. And he said, Khauf, I perform a story called Khauf in that. So he just said, Atul, jo aap pehle karte the, wo kahani ye nahi hai. And something, I mean, he was thinking about it and all that. And then after 10-15 minutes, I said, Gulzar sahab, kyunki main wo nahi hoon, jo main 10 saal pehle tha. So what happens in theater, if you are doing a play, suppose Nasir Bhai has been doing, say, for Waiting for Godot for so many years. So the first performance that he did, and probably what he does now, they will not match. But unfortunately, neither the first performance is recorded, nor the last performance is recorded. So in cinema, what happens is that the moment your director says, okay, that's about it. You cannot do anything about it, even 5 minutes or 10 minutes down the line, you cannot do anything about it. In web shows, what you can do probably is that, suppose you are doing a character, one thing that happens is that if a film story is told in 120, 140 minutes, in a web show, a story is told in, say, 400 minutes or something. So the writers get space to write the characters in a better way, according to me, with, you know, a lot of sheds and all that. And naturally, the actors, they get a lot of material. So that is one aspect of it. Secondly, if that show goes into, say, third season, fourth season, fifth season, seventh season, so 5 years down the line, you are doing the same character, but naturally, you are not the same because you have lived 5 years. So as a person, you are different. If, of course, you have kept your brain and eyes and ears open. And the character has grown because so have grown the writers and so has grown the director and all that. So your first episode of first season is recorded. Your 10th episode of your 10th season is recorded. And I imagine a beautiful graph as an actor, as a person in front of me. And I think that opportunity I do not get in theater, neither do I get it in cinema, to have that recorded journey as an actor and as a person doing the same character, mind you. So I think that is something which fascinates me. And when I see the shows like, you know, Game of Thrones or, you know, Breaking Bad and all that, which ran for whatever, 8-10 years, I think I really envy those actors who could get this opportunity. And that is one thing about these platforms. Second, of course, it's the future, as Nasir bhai said. This is because this medium is technology driven. So as the technology would change, this medium is bound to change. Today we are talking about OTT platforms and what is happening right here, right now. But I'm sure 2-3 years down the line, we'll be talking about something else because the technology has not stopped developing. So as an actor, as professionals in the field of art, we need to be extremely vigilant. You may be an actor or you may be a director, technician, all the more if you are a technician. I think as an artist, you have to be extremely vigilant if you are working in a visual medium. And you have to keep pace with what the technology is giving and the things that it is throwing at you.
Okay. Thank you very much, Nasir Saab. And Atul, wonderful talking to you as always. And all the best wishes for Bandish Matters. Thank you very much. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.